So students, in our last class, under chapter Human Health and Diseases, we were learning about response by the body under heading Acquired Immunity. First type of immunity we have learned, that is innate immunity, which is we have it by birth. There are some barriers, our body is designed like that. There are some barriers in the body, that is parts of our body which doesn't allow disease-causing microorganisms to enter. The body only doesn't allow disease-causing microorganisms to enter, then no chance for getting disease. So that is by birth we have, it is called innate immunity, we have already learnt in last class. Then we were learning about acquired immunity, if you remember. Acquired immunity, as we discussed in our last class, that any new pathogen, any new disease causing organism, for the first time it enters your body, okay, then the disease causing microorganism is called pathogen. When it enters the body, it first makes your body to show response. Our body shows response to this pathogen, but for that our body cells have to identify that pathogen is a foreign body. It is not a self, it is not a part of our body, it is from outside. It has to identify that it is foreign. So, identifying non-self, then once it confirms that, once it identifies that it is a foreign body which has come from outside, it is not a part of our body, then it produces response. That is, but it takes time, it's a slow process. It's a slow process or slow response. Our body shows slow response because our body cells take time. Our body cells take time to identify whether it is part of our body or from outside, that is self and non-self. Once it identifies it as non-self, then bone marrow produces two types of cells, that is B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. B lymphocytes produces antibodies. By producing antibodies, it protects our body, because antibodies are the chemicals, they are the proteins, they will surround the pathogen and they will kill it. Okay, and one more word I have to introduce here, that is pathogen is also called antigen. Antigen means, anti means against, it is against our body. Disease causing microorganisms or anything which comes from outside to our body, which is foreign body, is called antigen. Okay, anti means against, gen means to produce. It produces effects against our body. That is, any foreign body we call, foreign body means which is from the outside to our body. Anything outside, anything from outside enters our body, that is a foreign body. Suppose this chalk I will swallow, then this is foreign body, because this is not a part of my body. Okay, so it has come from outside. So anything which comes from outside, that is antigen. So one of the antigen is disease causing microorganism, that is pathogen. So if antigen is there here, then B lymphocytes in our body produces millions of proteins called antibodies. Okay, and those antibodies will surround this antigen like an army. Okay, then they will attack this antigen and they will kill it. See, I'm showing arrow mark here. All the antibodies will attack the antigen and they will kill it. They will surround it, like how army surrounds, you know, if any soldier from other country enters our country border, like one of the Pakistani Pakistani soldier enters Indian army, then definitely Indian army will surround him with all the guns, you know, some 8 to 10 people will surround him, then you know what happens. Like if he is carrying a weapon or he tries to attack, then counter attack they will do and they will kill him. That is a procedure. Okay, so like that. So B lymphocytes by producing antibodies, and those antibodies are the proteins which kills the antigen, any foreign body, so that we are safe. So it protects our body. Then B lymphocyte produces antibodies, but T lymphocyte doesn't produce any antibody. Then why they are required? T lymphocyte helps B lymphocyte to produce antibodies. That is why they are also called T helper cells. Both B and T lymphocytes are produced by bone marrow. Okay. Not only B and T lymphocytes, bone marrow produces all the types of blood cells. And all the cells in our body are primarily produced by bone marrow only. First, when bone marrow produces cells, they are called stem cells. Then stem cells can become any type of cell in our body. Okay. You already know about it in reproduction chapter, you have learnt about stem cells. So this is a process. Then same pathogen enters for the second time, we were learning, second time. Then enters the body, then response will be very fast because already our body cells know that type of antigen. They will identify very fast because they will have a memory of previous pathogen. Because this pathogen is coming for the second time. See, any person we see for the first time, we will not know that person. And second time when you see that person, you can identify because you have already seen him. Okay, like that. So second time the same pathogen comes, then body identifies very fast that is quick response. That is what we call anamnetic response, quick or anamnetic response, because already cells present in the body already know that type of pathogen. So now suddenly they will identify that it is a foreign body, and they already know what type of pathogen it is because already it has produced primary response. Now this will be secondary response, because second time pathogen entered, same pathogen, so it will be secondary response. But secondary response will be quick response compared to primary response. Then bone marrow produces B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. Then B lymphocytes produces antibodies quickly. Then T lymphocyte helps B lymphocyte. Then those antibodies will surround the antigen and they will kill them. Okay, so much we learnt about antibodies. What are those antibodies? How the structure of antibody looks like? That we will see now. We will see the structure of antibody, how single antibody looks like. These all things we are learning under heading
acquired immunity only.
So cartoon structure of antibody we will learn. Okay, so it will be almost like a Y shape when you see. Like a Y shape, I said. Step by step you can draw. You already know about it, but even then. I'm drawing it step by step so that it is easy for you to draw. See? Thus, this structure should be exactly opposite because this should go and fit into that. Okay, then in between that there will be disulfide bond. Name says disulfide bond. You can also write disulfide bond. Both are same. Di means two. Sulfide we write S, you know, SS bond like this. 2S will be there. Di means 2. Disulfide bond. See? So it is joined by disulfide bond. SS bond. Here also. You have to just write SS. Disulfide bond. Then even in the middle also you have to write that. Even here also you have to write disulfide bond like this. S bond. Okay, even at the bottom also you can write it like here. S bond. Okay, even here also you can write S bond. So disulfide bond will be there, and usually we say there are two chains here. Okay, that is heavy chain and light chain. What you see here in the center, the Y-shaped structure, this structure. See, if I should show in a different color, I'll show you in different color. What I am shading in orange color now, that chain is called as heavy chain. Because compared to these are called light chains. Compared to these two are very small. Okay, their molecular weight is less. And this is very big, you know, compared to this. These two small pieces, compared to that, this is big. So it is called, these two are called heavy chain. Then these two are light chains. How many are there? See, heavy chains are two in number. See, this is one. And this is second. This and this till here. This like this. See? One like this. Other one. Two. Okay. So then two are there here separately. These two. Those are light chains. So antibody structure, one formula is there. Simply we write that is H2L2. That is heavy chain 2 in number, that is 1 and 2, and light chains 2 in number. So L2, L means light chain, H means heavy chain, L means light chain. So H2L2 we say. Then if antigen comes, see, I think I have done a wrong diagram here, because see, this should be opposite like this, because antigen, that is a foreign body, will fit here. Okay, so this is should be opposite like this. Okay, because the foreign body, suppose foreign body or any bacteria, its shape should be like this now. Any bacteria which enters, its shape should be like this. This is the antigen, foreign body. Then only this will fit here, like this. See. If I should show in different color, you know. See. It should exactly fit here. So with the shape, they are shape specific. There are different type of antibodies. Based on what type of antigen is there, based on the shape of that, opposite to that shape will be the antibodies. So single antibody cannot work on all the antigens. Then you may think, okay, like what antibodies are produced? what antibodies are produced for polio. Okay, why it doesn't act on pneumonia? Because pneumonia causing bacteria shape is different. Then polio causing polio virus shape is different. So it is based on the shape of the antigen, exactly opposite shape which can easily fit. Okay, like that type of antibodies will be produced. So antibodies will be shape specific also, and they are antigen specific also. Antigen specific means one type of antibody is produced for that type of antigen. Like which type of weapon is required, it depends on which type of enemy is there, like that. Okay, so like too many are there to kill, then they may use bigger weapons. Okay, then only one person is there, then only single pistol is enough. Okay, so like that. So antibodies are pathogen specific, means antigen specific. It is very particular about it. Like one for one kind of antigen, one kind of antibodies will be produced. So this is the area where antigen can bind. So it is also called antigen binding site. Okay, the foreign body will fit there. So that is called antigen binding site. So the antigen is like this. The antigen is like this. Then only this can go and fit here. Okay, it will lock properly, like a lock and key, you know. Like one particular key is required to open particular lock. You have suppose Hero Honda bike key, you cannot turn on ignition of a TVS bike, because the key shape, what is there, you know, shape of the key and shape of the lock, it is exactly opposite, so that it will fit and open. So one single key you have, you cannot open all the doors. It will fit to only one particular door, like that. Antibody also fits to only one particular antigen. So it is specific. So this is a site where it can bind, foreign body will bind, that is called antigen binding site. When antigen binds to the antibody, then only antibody can kill the antigen. If the shape is different, then that antibody doesn't act on that kind of antigen. Okay, so that is based on that. Then what is exactly antibody? Chemically, what it is? Other name for antibody is immunoglobulin. Antibody is also called, other name is, you already know in first year, immunoglobulins. Okay, see, immunoglobulin starts with IG. Here G, globulin. So in short, we say IG. Other name for antigen. Okay, one more name is there for antigen. Antigen is also called immunoglobulins, in short IG. Okay, there are types of antigens. Like in your textbook, only four types they have given, that is IgA type, then IgM type, then IgE type, then IgG type they have given. One more is there, which is not given in the textbook, but it is IgD type. So there are five types of antibodies or five types of immunoglobulins, where Ig stands for immunoglobulin. Then what is immunoglobulin chemically? What it is? It is a protein, because you know that immuno word, we are talking about a prosthetic group. Then a globulin, what is there? That is a protein, circular oval shaped protein. Okay, so it is globulins. Type of proteins are there, you know, like simple proteins, conjugated proteins, all the derived proteins. Three types are there in proteins. Okay, under simple proteins you will see this globulin, which is round or oval shaped. So it is a protein. So antibody chemically, it is a protein, okay, which kills antigens or foreign bodies. I hope you understood. Easy to remember types of antibodies. I will give you short form. Like you can remember it as Ameg. Ameg means IgA, IgM, IgE, IgG. You can add one more, because fifth type is there, D type. Ameg D. okay, in short. Anyway, shortcut is not required. You will anyway remember it. But even then, I just mentioned it. Okay. Then, there are two types of immunities based on where exactly antibodies are produced. Okay. Antibodies are usually present in the blood. So, they are called humoral immune response. So, there are mainly two types of immunity based on where exactly antibodies are produced. So, if antibodies produced or released in the blood, so it is blood mediated, so that is why they are called humoral immunity. It is called humoral immunity. One more is there, cell mediated immunity, that is by T lymphocytes. Humoral immune response is by antibodies. One more is there, cell mediated immunity. This is second type. So I'll write in different colors. Cell mediated immunity, where immunity is because of T lymphocytes. T lymphocytes provide immunity. You know that T lymphocytes doesn't produce any antibodies. Then how they provide immunity? By different method. That is, it will help for T lymphocytes will help for identifying self and non-self. Means, which is our own body cells and which is foreign cells. This will help when, you know, if any foreign body enters, any bacteria or anything enters, then T lymphocytes have the capacity to identify whether it is a part of our body or from outside, which is self or non-self. So, where it is helpful? During organ transplant, you know, that is, suppose kidney failed, one person is there, both the kidneys failed, okay, he needs kidney donors. So, other person, he will donate one kidney, because with only one kidney also the person can be healthy and survive. Out of two kidneys, one person donated that kidney. Both of them have a donor and recipient, one who is receiving and one who is donating. Both of them have same blood group, but even though they have same blood group, you consider both of them have A plus blood group, okay, A positive, A positive. Even then, one process happens in the body, that is after organ transplant, that is from the donor, kidney is transferred to the recipient. The person received that kidney, but after operation, they may die because of T lymphocytes. You know why? There is one process called tissue rejection process. You have already learnt in microbes in human welfare chapter. Cyclosporine A is a chemical used as a immunosuppressive drug, no? That is for minimizing T lymphocyte effect. What T lymphocyte does? It identifies self and non-self. It identifies which is our own body cells and which is from outside, foreign cells. So, if organ transplant happened and the person received a donor's kidney, blood group matches, but the surrounding tissues around the kidney, suppose kidney is transferred, around the kidney what all cells are there, all those cells will reject that organ. Okay, they don't want that organ because it is from the other person. So, that tissue rejection process, that T lymphocytes identify that it is a foreign body, it is not from his own body, because the kidney is from other person, it is from outside. So, that is called tissue rejection process. Tissue rejects it, surrounding tissue will reject it, so that person may die because of tissue rejection. Okay, so, but it is very important for identifying self and non-self, because T lymphocytes, if they identify that the foreign body or bacteria is from outside, then only body can produce antibodies. Okay, otherwise antibodies are not produced. See, in the case of AIDS patient, you know, the virus, HIV, human immunovirus, it looks exactly same like human body. I mean, human it produces a DNA, and that DNA looks exactly same like human DNA. Okay, our own body cells cannot identify which is viral DNA and which is human DNA. Then there is no question of antibodies there. So in the case of AIDS, in the AIDS patient, antibodies are not produced because our own body cells, T lymphocytes, cannot identify which is viral DNA and human DNA, because viral DNA looks exactly same like human DNA. So like that. So this is one type of immunity provided by T lymphocyte, which is a cell, which is one type of cell. Okay, so it is also called cell mediated immunity. So these are the two types of immunity we have. Okay, so the next part what we have to learn is the tissue rejection process is also called graft rejection process, because graft means, you know, the other person's organ is taken, that is kidney is taken, and fixed to this recipient. That is called organ transplant or grafting, organ grafting. So it is called tissue rejection process or graft rejection process. So for that process, T lymphocytes are very important. Okay, so now we will learn about two types of immunity based on antigens and antibodies, that is active and passive immunity. Okay, active and passive immunity.